This is the Men's Room.
Forget it, man, and get with the countdown. Shake this square world and blast off for Kicksville. The Rippers, the Grasshoppers, the Hip Ones, all gathered in secrecy and flying high as a kite.
You're listening to the Men's Room with Miles and Thrill.
You're going to want to hang on. We got the Drunk in Charge, Kevin and Ryan Castle. We will soon spin with 10 huge songs that you did not know were covers. There are big tunes when they were covered by somebody else, and you know that to be the big hit and the original. But no, in fact, there was an original to that original. So 10 huge songs you didn't know were covers coming up with Sit and Spin. Our question, what was it about you as a kid that made your parents worry? 844-999-OLA.
Hello, Taylor. Welcome to the Men's Room.
Liquor and whores.
Liquor and whores.
All right, so when I was younger, just like that previous caller a couple ago, I had anger and kind of depression issues, kind of like a broken home thing.
All right.
But I would, you know, I'd get angry and then I'd just do random things as a kid. Like I used the WD-40 can and use it as like a flamethrower.
I feel like we all did that. Sure.
Not even out of anger.
Yeah, I mean, once you realize he could.
Just because of stupidity.
Well, it was the anger thing that got me on all those, like, fun medications that they, you know, through, I guess, my era, it was fun to just, instead of parent, you just drug them.
No, oh,
absolutely.
Oh, yeah, they called them what they call thinking drugs. Mm-hmm. Or concentration drugs.
Yeah, it was about a good 10 years where it's drugs. Like, look, you used to send your kid to boarding school. Now, look, don't look bad and do that. Just keep it on drug their ass.
People look bad, and I'll never forget this, Eric, because it pissed me off as an adult, as a parent, as somebody who was trying to fight to keep my kids off of those drugs and being a daily marijuana smoker.
Right.
The stigma that goes with being a daily marijuana smoker, why all these jackasses prescribe their kids drugs, it pissed me off to the point where I was just, nothing pissed me off more than knowing that marijuana, and I tried Wellbutrin and some other things.
Sure.
I knew it worked for me. And the fact that, you know, it was hypocritical, like, oh, he's a pothead. And I'm like, and you're giving your kids
because
drugs.
There's a stigma that they sell people, then there's an inherent truth that they don't like to tell you because you're protecting the people that make the goddamn pills and make money. It's very simple, but it's a fraud. Sure.
I was trying to protect the cartels or growing that sweet, sweet weed I was smoking.
Right. So what other things did you do?
So as I got older, my mom started to get a little more, like, you know, worried about me just because, you know, I was angry, but I was also, like, high all the time. Well, they'd leave me alone when I was about, I'd say, 9 or 10 in the mornings before I would go to school, so I'd have time in the house all myself. And for some reason, I would pull the couch away from the wall, and I'd just stab the S out of it a lot, like every day.
Every day.
All right.
And did they know you were doing this, or is the fact that you pushed the couch back up against the wall, they didn't know for a while?
Oh, they had no idea until it was time to move or anything, and then, you know, the back of the couch is gutted.
And obviously you're doing this out of frustration, anger, your bitterness. You said the broken home. Like, had your parents, divorced, I guess, fairly recent before all of this happened?
No, they divorced when I was younger, but it was my mom hated my dad. My dad loved my mom, so, like, when I would go to my dad's for the summer, it was like, no rules, have a blast, party, and then I'd come home. My mom's like, bedtime, this. So I was like, well, I hate you.
Right.
yeah. You know, and truth be told, when you're a part-time parent and you're only there for a month or a week or whatever,
if the court tells you that you can't interact with your kids, guess what? That parent party time.
Right. You can only do what you can do, man.
Right. Judge set it up that way, man. So guess what? No rules. Just it's like going to Outback Steakhouse.
It really is.
I just play didgeridoo with my kids. No rules. Just right.
I'd same thing, man. I go down and see, but I'd have 1 week a year with my dad.
Right.
And he lived in Florida. So when I go down there to see my dad, it's 1 week in Florida. We would go to Disney World. We would go to the beach.
Right,
we would
stay up as late as you want.
Then I come home to sucky-ass West Virginia, like, F you, Mom, this place sucks. I want to live with my dad.
Bedtime,
you know
dinner
what?
Time.
We go to Disney World. We go to SeaWorld. She'd be like, every day is in Disney World. Like, yes, it is in Florida.
It is there.
Right, exactly. Just have no freaking clue.
You can eat Oreos for dinner.
Exactly right. That was when Florida didn't have the stigma. It was actually a place where people wanted to go. Like, back in the day, like, there was a time, and I, you know, if you're listening to the radio and you're younger, you didn't realize this, but it wasn't a joke at one point in time. It was like the
place, just a state.
It was a place where people wanted to go.
Absolutely.
It was sunny, and they have tourism, and it wasn't, you know, just a running gag in the news. What was it about you as a kid that made your parents worry? 844-999-OLA.
Hello, Trevor. Welcome to the men's room.
Hola.
Hola.
Real quick, mega hug to Ted.
Oh.
I'll give him one of those.
Thanks, man.
And then, all right, so when I was a kid, my sister, who is 2 years older than me, collected, like, she just had a lot of Barbies, right, as girls do.
Mm.
And for some reason, I would chew the feet off of all of her Barbies.
You would chew it? Did you like the taste, or were you trying to annoy her?
You got one of the, you got a foot fetish?
To be honest, I was so young, I don't entirely, like, I remember doing it, but I don't know why, and I would just, and I do not have a foot fetish now.
Are you a cannibal?
No.
Okay, yeah, I'm all out.
But
took a while
to
answer.
To do that.
I know, let me, am I a cannibal? I mean, no. I eat some people, but not exclusively.
No, I used to eat chew, I don't think I swallowed them, but I would chew the feet off, and then also, another incident, she had a life-size Barbie doll. And
a life-size Barbie doll?
Yeah, probably like 4 feet tall.
Jesus, I've never seen that before.
I guess what I'd have done with it.
Yeah.
Who drilled this hole?
Why does she have the kung fu grip all the time? I don't know, Mom.
I would run around with this Barbie doll, and they would find me humping it in the closet, behind the house.
So were you was this your way of just entertaining yourself?
I guess so. I was still in diapers at the time. I would run around with it and hump it, but
because normally your parents would pull you aside if you're a boy playing with Barbie dolls and go like, hey, what's happening?
Not if you're doing that. What's going on?
But if it's a 4 foot size Barbie doll and he's I don't know that I would be shocked by this behavior.
It's odd, right? But on some level, somewhere in his unconscious brain, something has sparked
up. So do you think your parents were worried or were they concerned or no?
It was more so my dad. And he thought me running around with the doll, I think he and humping it, I thought he thought that was hilarious. Like kinda like an attaboy type thing. But he was not very thrilled with me like biting the feet off of her Barbie dolls, because obviously those aren't cheap.
Now, wait a minute. I'm just thinking, from my parental point of view, all right, my son decides he's going to chew, or he's going to mess with my daughter's Barbies. It's not that I want him to chew the feet off. Trust me, he's flushed them down the toilet. All types of terrible things have happened to the Barbie doll. I think, on some level, I'd feel more comfortable with him chewing the feet of the Barbie, only because kids put anything in their mouth and they'll chew on it, right? And it's different if I catch him humping the Barbie, but it's entirely different if I open the closet and he's hiding and doing it. You know what I'm saying? Kids just do whatever the hell they're going to do in front of you because they don't know if they should be embarrassed or whatever it is, right? So if my kid's humping the Barbie while I'm watching football, I go, hey, man, I appreciate the enthusiasm. I see where you're coming from, but you can't do that, right? But it'd be different when you open the closet.
If you're in there doing it.
Because now you specifically want private time, and right. You go, whoa. I mean, like, where did this come from? Like, there's a huge difference, man.
That's why I masturbate on my porch. Like, you know what I mean?
That way you let people know. Right, exactly. Like, hey, man, this isn't weird.
Too, right? It's like I always tell that story about hiding the sports section with Katarino Witt in it. Now, granted, my parents didn't care, right? But I felt the need to, like, hide it.
Well, because that's your go-to, man.
Yeah.
And you don't want anyone to accidentally throw it away? Katarina Witt, huh?
Wow.
I remember her name. I just want to pull it. It's been a while.
Yeah, yeah. Hey.
Yeah.
What was it about you as a kid that made your parents worry? 844-999-OLA. Now, if I'm your dad, I'm not worried about that. I'm like, I get it.
They thought it was hilarious and it embarrassed the crap out of me.
Oh, sure.
Oh, yeah. Like, when they found it, they were just like, what are you doing? I think my brother was like, are you hiding the sports page? And I was like, yeah, there's a picture of the ice skater.
I don't want to admit it. I kind of am into ice skating.
You ever use the Sears catalog in a pinch?
Sure.
You're my age.
No,
so
I know. We didn't have anything.
And listen, this thing would get delivered to your house, and it was like the size of a phone book, and your parents would look like dishwashers. Mm-hmm. And I mean, man, they went to bed, you grabbed that thing, and you're looking at the bra section. But I want you to understand, these are the sexy picture the bra you'd have to buy your grandmother right now if she said stop by the store and
I'd
buy
rub
me a
one
bra.
Out to NFL football sheets that I wanted. Like, man, oh, dude, they got every team on logo on there, man.
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
It so did not matter.
No, it didn't.
Like Victoria's Secret, there was some higher.
That was a game changer,
yeah,
man.
That stuff was already being sent around.
Because my mother would always do that. They just delivered the Cadillac today. I can't find it anywhere. And I'm playing like, maybe I took it out with recycling. It was under my bed.
It was either Fredericks of Hollywood or one of these.
Oh, that was like
the Hollywood was like the dirty.
Straight up like a whore.
Bathing suit one that came out like once a year. And I mean, it was just like, I don't know who's sending this, but they love me.
Look, man, Fredericks of Hollywood was like Hustler if Victoria's Secret was Playboy. Oh, this is dirty. Like, everything they sell is to get laid. I was all about it, man. The good old days.
What was it about you as a kid that made your parents worry? 844-999-OLA.
Hello, Caleb. Welcome to the men's room.
Hey, guys. How's it going?
Hola. Well, how you doing?
I'm doing great.
Good.
So, as a kid, I had a really unhealthy obsession with any kind of knife. And I actually ended up starting an unofficial black market in my elementary school, selling, trading knives and any kind of weapons, not in school, but...
Was this like in the vein of pocket knives and throwing stars and stuff like that?
You know, it started out as like cheap dollar store pocket knives, but ended up getting to the level of like fixed blades, machetes...
But as kids, we used all of those things in practical ways. Like, if you had a machete, you would go out and hack weeds. If you had a sickle, you could use that, too. Throwing stars people just had laying around because it was a cool thing to do, and they threw it at a dartboard or a wall. I mean, I could go into anybody's apartment from the time that I was 17 to 19 and guarantee
nunchuck,
three or four
swords. Right.
You could back yourself in the back of the head, man. Right. You had blow darts. I mean, people just had weird weaponry laying around.
Now, to be fair, most of them weren't dealers in school.
No, it's just they had it.
Right.
Everybody had it. Like, oh, man, check out my new throwing star. Like,
and it's sticking nothing.
Is badass. No, the wall. Thump. You got a rental. Like, why did I give my security deposit back?
right. Sorry,
sir.
Man.
What was it about you as a kid that made your parents worry? 844-999-OLA. Hang on. We'll get your emails on the way and the drunken charges in as we will sit and spin with 10 huge songs that you didn't know were covers. That's all coming up next. You are listening to the Men's Room Radio Network.
Bitches, you're listening to the Men's Room.
Hang on, Drunk in Charge, Ryan Castle coming in. We'll sit and spin today with 10 huge songs.
Huge.
You know we're covers. That is coming up with the Drunk in Charge. First time for a few emails here for the Men's Room at mensroomlive.com.
You've got mail. You've got mail.
Our question, what was it about you as a kid that made your parents worry? Ola Bicholas, my parents were concerned about my younger brother as a child because he would go to the bathroom literally anywhere. He would whip it out and pee in parking lots. He would make it a point to go outside to pee, and one time even dropped his pants and took a nest in the camouflage coat rack at Kmart. My dad didn't notice at first because he was filling out papers for his hunting license. Once I pointed out what was happening, he swooped on my brother, and we left very quickly. He still pees outside, but luckily uses the bathroom for number twos.
It's now becoming a problem with my son. Like 2 years ago, I was trying to encourage him to pee outside just based on where we were, and he would not do it. And I'm like, dude, it's okay. Just go beyond the tree line. Pee, right? Wouldn't do it. Whatever. Let it go. Fast forward. Now, every time he has to go to the bathroom, I'll just pee here. I'm like, bro, we're standing in a mall. Like,
yeah, this is not good.
You
this
can't
is, this
pee.
Is the grocery,
you know what I mean?
The produce like, section of
right.
the grocery store.
No. Yeah. Not here.
Guys, my parents always worried about me listening to that evil, heavy metal and hardcore music. Must be something about those album covers by Maiden and bands named Judas Priest and Black Sabbath. Rock on that from Jay. That wasn't uncommon.
Oh, I love
the same
exact
thing. It was a different time where it was that that heaven and hell fear through Christianity. You're going to go to hell,
right.
All that stuff. And it was just, and there were a lot of people who really believed that you were going to go to a fiery place and burn.
It was,
and so they would tell you that and try to scare the living. I mean, you would never do that to your kid today, but then they tried to scare the living hell out of you by saying you're going to go to this place that's on fire and where all these bad people are. And
but
all this
I
crap.
Think that was just like there's always that, right? So our parents are growing up, and it's if you don't conform or if you smoke weed, this happened, right?
Yeah.
That didn't work. So now it's music. If you do the, if you listen to, that didn't work. Then it's video games. If you like, so they're always trying to find something why you're going to go to hell. Either we're all going to go to hell, or maybe they're just wrong.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, totally.
But every generation
updates.
Right. There's a it's Grand Theft Auto before that. It's Iron Maiden before. Well, it's weed.
But it doesn't seem like the hell thing is there as much anymore. Like that
it's
whole
too
fire
hokey.
And right, exactly.
It's just too hokey.
But I have to think it's still there in the Catholics.
In a small group of people who really believe that.
But what we're saying, the difference is when we were growing up, this was the universe.
It was scare tactics for everybody.
Not like you could be Catholic, but then you could be in CNN like, you're going to go to hell. What are you talking
about? Fire and brimstone stuff.
Right.
Like, Jesus. Guys, I stole stuff as a kid. I would take toys and stash them in front of the yard and pretend I found them out there. I broke into neighbors' homes, got caught one time by my own error. The other time, I was ratted out by my sister when I did not share my haul of high C drink boxes with her. She threatened, so I gave in. She still told. Once a neighbor had things stolen from their home, and they pointed the finger at me. I swore I didn't do it, as I did before, but this time, it was true. I did some personal investigation, and the kids of the home stole and tried to pin it on me, as I was a likely suspect. Mm-hmm. I did not grow out of it as an adult and pay the consequences. Now I don't take anything that is not mine. Seems simple enough. That from Jeremy.
Well, you know.
See, you kept thieving, though.
It did, but right, yeah, when you're an adult punishment changes, you go, it's not worth it.
I think the only thing I stole as a kid is the only thing I really stole as an adult, which is candy.
I say childhood,
things
adulthood.
Don't change, man. You want what you want. You
right.
It's not like all of a sudden you're like, oh, I'm going to collect hockey cards and steal these.
No, candy's good.
You're going to keep getting what you get. Guys, I had a birthmark that was very small on my back right shoulder, maybe a couple millimeters wide as a kid. When I hit puberty, it started growing and then took over my shoulder. Then it got hairy. Went to dermatologist as a kid to make sure it wasn't cancer. It wasn't. Then, as an adult, went to a tattoo artist to make it a boar. My birth year, Zodiac. May as well embrace the weird. Attached pics from after I got it a long time ago. That was pretty cool.
You know what I mean? I will say, the tattoo's cool, and how it works with the birthmark is cool, but I'm going to be dead honest with you, man. That hairy thing is weird, dude. I mean, because if you have not seen the picture, understand. Picture him, like, chest up, and it's like his right shoulder is hairy and nothing else.
Guys, a cheery story for you. When I was growing up, I was picked on and suspended from school constantly, on top of being a relatively fat kid, to the point that my mom twice made the statement that he can't fight worth a damn, but I'd hate to be the one he lands on. Now, with 10 years plus of combat martial arts training, numerous fighting championships, and street fights under multiple black belts, I don't think she has the same thing to worry about today. Keep those knives sharp, bitches. That from Bacon. Guys, when my brother was young, up to about 12 years old, he had a serious bedwetting and nervous bladder problem. This even got to the point where we had to carry him around in a special bottle in the car for him to use while driving in the car because my parents were tired of having to pull over every time we go to the bathroom.
A special bottle. You mean just like a Coke bottle?
Yeah, he did finally grow out of it, but it did concern my parents to the point where they had to consider help from some sort of specialist. That from Cujo. And guys, I was 15 years old, bleach blonde freshman in high school, and my mother discovered I had plastered my bedroom walls with all things Kiss. She then looked in my closet and found all my Kiss-themed apparel. Tube tops, tank tops. I'm still pissed off that she destroyed all of my high school Kiss stuff. Get it? Destroyered?
Hey. Right, she was hotter than hell.
Oh, and then
saw.
I got grounded for 6 months for having Kiss stuff in my possession. Rock
you
on.
Should always listen to the elder.
That from wow. That was a deep one. That one from Loretta. We have time for a few extra emails here for the Men's Room at mensroomlive.com.
You've got mail.
Circus in here. I'd like to say happy birthday to my son, Joe. He is the big 1-3. Can you give him a, your penis is too small, and some dirty German talk about being a teenager? Thanks, guys. You are the best. That from Chris. Again, he is the big 1-3, the big 13.
Yeah, I know why you have an erection. I know what you do with it. Happy birthday.
Yeah, stay in school, kids.
Guys, would love it if you'd wish my son Hunter a happy birthday. He is 19 years old, and we listen to you guys ever since we moved here in 2008. How about an owl hitting the window and a next caller? Thanks, guys. Appreciate it. That from Kelly.
Cut that bitch off. Next caller.
Please, may I have an original fish sandwich, turtle sex, and the boys and Robin talking all over themselves about Olympic curling and pork loin. You're the bestest, good-looking. That from Jania.
Fish sandwich.
I actually don't know anything.
Why do you bring up curling the pork loin? Because for me, that's a euphemism for mashed potatoes. I'm going to go curl the pork loin. I don't know what the hell I'm talking about.
That really gives you the energy.
Hola, my wife Jessica is turning 31 and has always wanted to visit Germany and Australia. So, could she get the dirty German thrill to convince her to see Germany and Ted from Melbourne to convince her to go down under? Thanks, guys. That from David.
Yeah, visit me in Germany. I will make sure you are very safe. I am a police officer. I'll show you my badge.
Hey, mate.
Sorry, mate. I forgot to go down under.
Hey, Ted here from Melbourne. You know, we got cops down there, too. I'll show you my nightstick. Main thing is, though, come over. Cherry ripe.
Guys, it's my bedtime. It's my buddy Josh's 37th birthday. It says bedtime.
Ah, okay.
Maybe Lily wants to bed Josh. Can I get a giant bong hit and an original fish sandwich for him? Happy birthday, Josh. That from the lovely Lily.
Fish sandwich.
Gentlemen, I want to wish my wonderful husband, Chris, a very happy 40th birthday today. He'd like nothing better than some dirty Germans talking about Star Wars. Love, Gina.
Yeah, oddly enough, you bring up the Star Wars, even though it kind of looks like R2-D2. He's a bit taller, but hairy like Wookiee.
Yeah, since I'm a dirty German, I grew up having lots of sex. So honestly, I'm not quite familiar with the Star Wars.
Yeah.
All right, guys, here you go. Happy birthday to you, bitches.
Yaws of Dirty Germans, brought to you by Men's Room Original Sausage. Available through Uli's World Famous Sausage, mensroomlive.com, and other fine retailers. Mmm, Schweinefleisch.
One more here. Guys, you guys had last week, you read some absolutely ridiculous names that parents have created for their babies in 2017. Mm-hmm. So I decided to offer some unique names that parents might not want to use in 2018 that will definitely set their babies apart from other babies. These names aren't as stupid as the list the other idiots came up with. They're just much more offensive and much worse, but they will make your kid unique.
Okay.
Some of these names are messed up and offensive, but away we go. For boys, number 10, Jolly Joe.
Jolly Joe, okay.
Number 9, Speedo. Number 8, Anus. Can't say number 7. Well, number 6, Colostomy. Number 5, Scuzz. Followed by Gland, Boof, Weinstein, and Castle.
Gland.
That's right, Castle, you're number 1. For girls, Skankoid, Easy, Yeasty, Jabba, Mulva, Cocky Nose, Swallow, Vagisil, Fluffer, and Castle. There you go.
Wow. I am just on fire.
You are. You really are.
Yeah. There you go. Still to come, the return of what you don't need to know, and we have more things you don't need to know. But first, the Drunken Charge is in the house, and once again, it's time to sit and spin.
Yes, friends, it's time once again for Sit and Spin. Let's gather around the old radio and listen to some swellerific new music.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it seems like every time I play Hurt by Nine Inch Nails on the radio, some music neophyte has to send me a text or call in and say, who's ruining this Johnny Cash song?
And you tell
it's
them?
It's so offensive. Right, and I go, because it's the original, dumbass. Mm-hmm.
It is.
But, you know, a lot of songs that we know and love and are huge hits are cover versions. And you may not know the original version. Some of these songs are very, very old. Some of them were never big hits. And there's a chance you just never actually heard it. Now, here's the problem with having someone cover your song and have it become a huge hit. Here it is. That's because the song was fine. You were the problem.
Could be.
You wrote a good song, but you don't perform it well.
So we really like the song. Yeah. We just don't like you doing the song.
So are you playing the original version?
So no, I'm going to play the original version.
Let's see if we can guess the artist.
Yeah, I think most of you are able to. And some of them were bona fide hits, the original versions. But a lot of them you've probably never heard.
And most of the time we'll play, I know, Sound of Silence was big for Disturbed.
I mean, that one you know.
And what Zombie Now is being covered.
It's Bad Wolves.
Not a bad version.
Big song.
We've done Careless Whisper, a few other that
Seether did Careless
not
Whisper.
Really from the rock genre that's kind of transferred.
But but these songs you understood they hit to be the person who you thought was the original artist when in fact that's just not the case.
Number 10.
What's she doing with her fingers?
Strumming her
or what?
was that? Roberta Flack?
Roberta Flack, very good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and that was a cover.
The Fugees did it in 97, and they won a Grammy for it.
One time.
She took the song all the way to number one
right.
in 1973.
These are 10 huge songs that you didn't know were covers on Sit and Spin.
Number nine.
Did not know this was a cover, but I have no idea who this band is.
So this is Tears for Fears doing Mad World, but you probably know the Gary Jules version that was in Donnie Darko in 2001, which is very, very, very depressing. If you listen to the lyrics of this song, it's sad, but what Tears for Fears does is, it's kind of funny that I'm dying.
Right.
10 songs you didn't know were covered on Sit and Spin.
Number eight.
I grew up with this crap, too, and I can't think of the artist.
So Salt-N-Pepa did it, En Vogue did it. This is Linda Lindell from, what year is this? Like 1965 or something?
Sounds pretty true to the, I mean, it is the original. It sounds true to the covers.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
I guess
it's she sounds true to what they did later.
Exactly. She sounds exactly like the thing that she wrote herself, because it's hers.
And the video En Vogue was great.
Yes.
Yeah.
Is this a masturbatory thing you're saying?
You know, they were singing in a nightclub. They had all nice dresses. And young Ted very much liked it.
That's what it was. It was their dresses. They had very nice dresses.
Well, young
the long,
Ted.
Yeah, the long gloves.
Young Ted fashionista.
Very much. Number seven. Cause I am your lady. Oh. And you are my man.
Who is this?
This is Jennifer Rush. Did this song originally. Celine Dion had big success with the cover. So this actually was big in the UK, but never happened in the States. Celine Dion covers it in 1994.
They will know in the United States, and I'll steal it.
And it becomes huge, but this chick actually co-wrote the song, so she made a ton of money.
Oh, I bet
Celine
she
Dion
did.
Version.
Wow.
Dang. Well,
good for her.
That's
another great example of, so the song isn't the problem, it's you, because this is pretty true to the other version.
Right. Though. 10 huge songs that you didn't know were covers on Sit and Spin.
Number six.
You ain't nothing but a hound dog. Been snooping around the door. You ain't nothing but a hound dog. Been snooping around the door.
1952. This is Big Mama Thornton.
Big Mama Thornton.
Elvis has a big hit with it in 1956.
Okay.
I
think I like her version a little bit. Stealing from other artists.
Stealing from
oh,
black
yeah.
People.
That was.
Yeah, stealing black people's.
He even
music.
Stole the ghetto.
Right.
I'm going to Great
Zion. I'm taking it all.
That's right.
That's right.
The peanut butter
I'm living in the ghetto
sandwich.
Now. I'll die on the toilet.
You can't have that peanut butter banana sandwich. I'm stealing. These are 10 songs you didn't know were covers on Sit and Spin.
Number five.
Red wine.
No.
The Jewish Elvis?
You didn't know Jew Elvis, did UB40's Red Wine, did you?
I had no idea.
I always thought this was a UB40 song, too, and I like Neil Diamond. I had no idea this is a Neil Diamond song.
I couldn't tell you another UB40 song.
No.
Wow.
Yeah.
I can't.
I think they only did one song.
And they kind of did.
He also wrote I'm a Believer, too, right? And that wasn't the biggest... That was the biggest version of that song.
Did he record it or write it? I'm a believer.
I thought he was the writer of that song. Maybe I'm wrong.
The Monkees, I'm a believer.
Yeah, but I believe that was a Neil Diamond song originally, but the Monkees made it more famous than Neil Diamond.
There you go. We should have put it on the list.
That's right. 10 songs. Well, this is even bigger. As far as UB40, this was a huge, hit. 10 songs you didn't know were covers on Sit and Spin.
Number four.
What you want, honey, you got it.
That's right, ladies. The feminist anthem from 1967 was written by a man.
Mm-hmm. Don't worry, it's Raining Men, written by a man.
That's
a couple of those.
Otis Redding did this song originally.
I think his version is slang for getting late.
Yes.
Yeah. He's like, when I get home,
feminist
I need some respect.
Anthem.
It's a dude. This is about you sing it for what you want. He wanted to get some ass.
Yeah, the original wasn't Sock It to Me, Sock It to Me. It was different. 10 songs you didn't know were covered.
Number three.
Love is a burning thing.
She's got an amazing voice.
I just never did not know. Who is it?
So this is Johnny Cash's sister-in-law, Anita Carter. She did the song originally, wrote it with June Carter Cash.
And then Johnny stole it. And reaped untold fortune.
Right.
Let me go ahead and make this famous.
These are 10 songs you didn't know are covers on Spin Spin.
Number two. Next I read to you. Now I wrote for you.
So this song is pretty much synonymous with 80s British synth pop that was actually originally done by an American singer named Gloria Jones in 1965.
Since then today, these are 10 huge songs that you did not know were covers, and we have made it to number one.
Number one.
Oh, wow.
That is Robert Hazard doing Girls Just Want to Have Fun. Huh. Not a Cyndi Lauper song.
I would have not guessed that.
Written by a dude.
Written by a dude.
Unbelievable. What's going on here today?
You want that fun because he told you to. Right.
Thank you, Ryan Castle. We appreciate it. All right, still to come, we're going to drink a toast with a shot of the day. What you don't need to know is got more things that you really just don't need to know. That's coming up next. You are listening to the Men's Room Radio Network.
Back to the Men's Room with Miles and Thrill.
Coming up, we'll drink a toast with a shot of the day. Speaking of drinking, we're going to do a little outdoor drinking. Men's Room Red Festival, Bob and Tullis. We'll see you Saturday, June 23rd, Enumclaw Expo Center for a full day of outdoor drinking. We've got live music all day long. Wyatt Olney and the Wreckage, Washed in Black, Woodshed, new originals
of
play.
That is correct, sir.
And backed by popular demand. Goddamn Killjoy the clown.
Hey, man.
Killjoy.
Look, dude, we didn't know anything about this cat last year. He goes out on stage, right? Does whatever it is, but he crushed it.
Yep.
People loved him. So, yeah, he's coming back. But, yeah, new originals playing again as well. Mm-hmm. But it's one of, like, the two shows we play, right? So every time we play, people, you always go shirtless. Well, one, I go shirtless because I'm dead sexy. Beyond that, also, it's hot. But what I'm going to do this year, right? And I don't know how long it's going to last because it gets... Part of the reason I hate wearing crap up there, you get sticky, you get sweaty, it's uncomfortable. Sure. But I was thinking, because it is Red Fest, right? Red Festival. I think this year I'm going to rock a red cape, all right? I'm not trying to play the Superman thing. It's just like, no. I don't even want to plant the seed in your head that I'm like Superman. No, listen to me. This is my thought, right? Like, it's Red Festival. And I realize, as I'm thinking about this. Like,
shirt, no shirt with the cape.
You're going to wear a red shirt?
Well, no, I don't own a red shirt. That's why I thought of the cape, right? So I'm going through my clothes. I'm like, I actually don't own anything red to celebrate the fact. This was my thought, right? And then, well, I don't want to buy a red shirt. Then I'm like, you know what? Wear a cape. That's much more sensible. But there are a few occasions where I feel that a grown man such as myself could wear a red cape. Mm-hmm. And I believe at Red Festival, okay. Not only will I don a red cape, but if I play my cards right, what I'd like to do is, like, silkscreen the logo in the back, all right? So... Right, so
that's cool.
That way you don't confuse me for Superman, Miles. Sure, right. That way you know it's me.
Okay.
That's just an idea. You should get
We've
a red cape.
We've got live music all
if
day.
If I buy you a red cape, will you wear a red cape with me?
Sure. I wear a red condom. Over 20 beers available at Red Festival, including Men's Room Original Red.
We you and Ted?
We should hand those out.
No, that's a lot of capes.
I'll wear a red condom.
I will order capes for everyone on the show. The show.
I'll wear one.
Will you wear a cape? Because I look under. She says yes. Mm-hmm.
Tickets are on sale now, mensroomlive.com. And keep in mind, a portion of net proceeds from the event are going to benefit our friends with the Seafair Foundation and Fisher House. We will have Men's Room Original Sausage there. There's going to be more food vendors, more games for you to play, freestyle motocross going on, aerialists. Those guys had to cut it short last year because it started to rain, so they didn't really even get a chance to do their thing. They'll be able to do it this year at Red Festival. So.
We want to clear up one thing from last year, Miles. It was a slip of the tongue. Not aerialist. Aerialist.
A lot of
people were disappointed.
Yes, they were.
When you said aerialist.
Boobs.
Yeah. So I bet you their nipples are red.
Belly dance.
Red Festival.
And live music all day. Get those tickets
now. Brought my red nipples.
They're only $20 American, and you can get them
whatever
at Men's Room Live.
If you don't own red clothes, right, and you show up a red, but just cut out two holes in your shirt so we can see your red nipples, good enough.
Yeah, Ted's got plenty of red clothes for you to borrow. That's a fact. All right, we're going to drink and toast coming up in seconds, but first...
We're full of useless information, And you have far too many brain cells not to let us kill a few. So lend an ear while the men's room shares what you don't need to know.
Every once in a while, meaning twice, on what you don't need to know, we've decided to bring to you some terms that you really just, and things and information that you really just don't need to know. So,
I mean, there's today, nothing practical.
Today, well, it's not that it's not practical or interesting, it's just...
Well, it show up on... To me, the litmus test is Jeopardy. Like, if it won't maybe. Even show up on Jeopardy, really, you've wasted your
maybe.
Time.
Maybe. Let's go here. All right. Believe it or not, peanuts are one of the ingredients in dynamite. Did you need to know that?
It's very interesting. I did not need to know.
Okay. The longest one-syllable word in the English language is...
Yes!
That is incorrect, but it's a great answer.
Yes!
The longest one-syllable word in the English language is screeched.
Okay, all right, that makes right. sense.
No word in the English language rhymes with month, orange, silver, or purple.
But how do you give a purple nurple?
Nurple, not in fact a
it
word.
It needs to be a word because yes. you say purple nurple, people mm-hmm. know what it is.
A cat has how many muscles in each ear?
12.
Six. 32.
32.
And finally, it is impossible to sneeze with your eyes open. It's
I've
physically
heard that.
Impossible.
Is
it? Yes.
They'll pop out.
Me. They will pop out. That's absolutely
oh,
right.
Oh, then I'm not going
to
try.
Who wants that to happen? All right, Mom, and we made it to drinking time.
Somebody out there deserves to be recognized. And the men's room knows just who it is. So to you, we say, bottoms up, sailor. You're the toast of our shot of the day.
Drink time it is, and as usual, we head to the drink desk and Stephen Thrill Hill to find out who we're toasting.
Yes, indeed, and today we toast a woman in St. Augustine, Florida, who, well, this past Saturday, she was sitting with another man in the middle of a parking lot. Someone called the cops on them because they were also doing drugs while sitting in a car together in the parking lot. The cops showed up. They searched her car, and sure enough, they found drug paraphernalia and a substance that tested positive for crystal meth. No big surprises there. This woman was arrested for possession of meth. Her name is Crystal Methvin. Crystal Methvin.
Crystal Methvin.
Was arrested for crystal meth. The stunning thing about her is you do a little more research. This is the second time that Crystal Methvin has been arrested for possession of crystal meth.
Don't need Does she come from like a methy family?
She comes from the Methvin family, Ted.
Methvin. Methvin, yeah. If your last name is Methvin, right, aren't you just setting your kid up for this? I want to say she's like 23 years old, so like meth was a thing.
Yeah, and I mean...
If my last name was Kane, I'm not naming my kid Coke. I mean, it's just how it goes, right?
Yeah.
If my last name's Juana, my daughter's name is not Mary.
And it's Crystal.
Crystal Methvin, yeah. No. So yesterday, Crystal Methvin, for the second time, I want to say in the last 4 years, arrested for possession of crystal meth. Is it a self-fulfilling prophecy?
Her name is Crystal Methvin.
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 Yes.
Methvin.
Yeah, it's much different. We pour this booze and we drink this booze because we think it's yummy.
Yummy.
So over the tongue and down the throat to party in our tummies.
Hola, hola, bitchola.
Let's get to caller 9 in the line right now for Profile This. 844-999-OLA.
Hola. The shenanigans continue on the Men's Room Radio Network.